Now let's be real. Some places just have that sexy feel. The sense of indulging whatever we feel. Celebrityville, built stylishly but cleverly still. Chances are after this you'll never be thrilled. Worldwide royalty walking past while Oscar winners play the supporting cast. I'm psyched. Forgive me if I'm talking fast, but this one's special. There haven't been many winners of Monaco as yet that didn't benefit from the domino effect. Some of the best lengths and sequences test strengths and weaknesses. Tension, grievances, you can sense how deep this is. From every angle and curve to every entangling swerve, it's all about handling nerve, which is the key. Unlocking the door to Monaco's rich history. Welcome to the only tunnel in a Grand Prix. Quite lucky to have this one, aren't we? The princess used to grace the track in style, or more style than Jensen running his victory mile. Still, beneath the helmet, you know there's a smile. It's like a cocktail of elegance and Mardi Gras. Picture Moss having a laugh in Ferrari cars. Picture all the little moments, from banter with opponents to forgotten times when teams would tamper with components before the days of secrecy. Last minute adjustments to the car just before the race for all adjacent teams to see. The first one was won by a Brit. And over the years, the Brits have done quite a bit. So when you dig into the archives, try and spot the blur of colour known as the Flying Scot. It's not a bird or a plane, it's Stuart hurtling across. Three-time winner alongside Stirling Moss. Both of them follow four-time winner Prost. In 1989, the four-time winner lost to a man whose record remains untouched still. Senna had an amazing run, such skill. That's not to say others haven't done much still. Schumacher was dominant not too long ago and he'll still the beloved Mr. Monaco. But of late, Red Bull have been known to steal the lead. Three victorious years owing more to skill than speed. And we all should feel the need to take heed of Alonso. There's no question his game has been strong, so we'll have to wait and see if he can play these cards right. Maybe more consistently than Mercedes cards might. Because as easily as they may qualify one day, we know the tyres tend to struggle by Sunday.
I've never seen the tyres behave this way.
See, there's no such thing as an immaculate race, but mistakes on this one could be a smack in the face. Brabham was on the victory fast track until he crashed on the last corner of the last lap. But in true Monaco fashion, it's all one big gamble. You just play your cards close to your chest, hope for the best, and pray your cards cope with the stress of this ultimate test. Here we go again. Time to separate the boys from the men. You could be smoother than butter. Let's just hope you're on a roll. Because there's no telling where it's gonna go in Monaco.